All right, Teresa, you let me know when you're ready. Okay, A, enter, working trot. X, halt, salute.
If you want me to read it, there's papers in the red bag that you can just pass over.
I can just give you one of these. Sorry, we suck. Start again. She's gonna read it. Totally our fault. We're trying to get things together over here. We're a mess. All right. So she's gonna read it, that way I can just kind of pay attention.
Yeah. Okay, A, enter, working trot.
All right, nice turn there, good.
X, halt, salute. Proceed, working trot.
Yeah, make sure he's all the way immobile before you halt, good.
C, track right.
Yeah, so he really came off the center line there. But very good getting all the way up here to C. Good. Yep, and good job in that corner.
D, circle right, 20 meters.
And don't overbend him on the straight line. There you go. And it might help if you shorten up that outside rein a little bit, because I can see it flopping around from here, and that doesn't leave him very supported. There. Good job only touching the wall at E. But yeah, that outside rein is just way too loose to be supportive. Good. And good job going back to the wall right at E. Good.
K, X, M. Change rein.
All right, good job in that corner. You're going across the diagonal, yeah.
Gotta get to K.
Okay, so next time we'll work on that corner. And try to keep them as straight as you can on the diagonals, because you shouldn't have one bend one way or the other. Good.
Between C and H, working canter, left lead.
Yeah, just set them up for that a little bit more and make sure you get in that corner.
E, circle left 20 meters, sorry. Circle.
There you go. Yeah, so the circle is a little bit big, but that's okay. You didn't know that there was a circle in there. That's too late. That's okay.
Between E and K, working trot.
Quiet hands.
A, circle left, 20 meters, rising trot, allowing the horse to stretch forward and downward.
Yeah, so try and keep your shoulders back. But that was a really nice downward from your canter to your trot. There, I'm very...
A, circle left, or before A, shorten the reins. A, working trot.
Walk.
Between A and F, medium walk. Sorry, I was really late. F to E, change rein, medium walk.
Yeah, so again, just make sure if he's on that straight line that he's not bent one way or the other. You want him to be all the way straight on the diagonal.
E to M, change rein, free walk.
Yep, good turn there. Just make sure you get all the way to the wall at E. There, and that's a much better free walk. His free walk is actually faster than his medium walk, which means that we need to work on that medium walk a little bit, but this is a very nice free walk for him.
M, medium walk.
Good.
C, working trot.
Good. Yep, setting him up a little early. Good change in your diagonal there.
E, circle left, 20 meters.
Yeah, so make sure the bend is correct. A little bit big on that side. Yeah, so we could have a little bit more impulsion. And make sure you make it all the way back to E.
F, X, H, change rein.
Okay, that's a pleasant trot. Good, yep, all the way in that corner.
Yeah. Yep, F-X-E, or F-X-H.
Yeah, at the trot, it's that, yeah. Yes, but don't let him, that's okay, there was just some test.
Between C and M, working canter right lead.
Good. Yeah, same thing at that corner.
B, circle right, 20 meters.
No, on the next test, just make sure you make your circle in the middle at B and not at the end.
Okay.
That's okay. Just keep them going for now. That's good.
Good job. Between B and F, working trot.
Yeah, so you just broke a little bit early, but that circle was a little funky, so that's okay.
A, down center line. X, halt, salute.
Yeah, so support him with that outside rein there. That way that shoulder doesn't fall. Good. There. Nice halt. Yep, but again, make sure he's all the way stopped first. There you go. Good. All right, so what did you think, Teresa?
I think he was trying.
Okay.
His canter is not rush gallop.
Right.
Canter.
Right.
Because I'm thinking,
yeah.
Why isn't that their step anymore?
Yeah, right? Yeah. So, which I think helps with you saying that in your head. Yeah. How do you feel about your corners?
I try. Like she said.
Yeah, it's really deep up here. What about the ones at the end? Because remember, you have to go around and do these.
I feel like he wasn't so deep in the corner as much as he needed to.
Right. So make sure that when you're going in those corners, you really, especially when you have to come across the diagonal, because this corner is so small when you have to come across, you really need that full time to go line him up for the diagonal.
Mm-hmm.
So just that was the biggest concern there was, just those corners.
20-meter circles were 20-meter circles, right?
For the most part, yes. You tend to, when you hit B, you want to turn off the wall and then just kind of go straight across instead of making it like a big bubble, like a circle, you know? So, but that's okay because it was 20 meters. It was just a little bit like, that end was big and then this end was small. So it probably did end up being 20 meters, but it was just misplaced a little bit. It was just two steps too far of the park. So
well,
just make sure that the circles are even on either side of the line.
I mean,
I know. Trust me, dressage is impossible. But, you know, that's why we love it, right? But yeah, other than that, it was good. Your free walk was actually, the free walk was actually better than the medium walk. He seemed like he had more impulsion, so just make sure that you carry that impulsion through on the medium walk as well. Because once you hit the E to do the free walk here, it was very nice. He tried to stretch. He was like getting his steps. You know, he was doing everything correctly. But I think you were maybe worried about him trotting or something, maybe.
Yeah.
And so you were a little tense on him, and so it made him have that shorter stride in the medium walk when you really still want him.
Well, I let him walk fast, but I didn't want him
to trot. Right. No, I know. There's that fine line there. I know.
But then
just on both halts, make sure that he's all the way stopped before you even think about saluting. You know, because they will dock you on that. He needs to be all the way, 4 feet. And once you feel like, okay, he's got all 4 feet and he is not moving, then salute. Because you just want to, like, halt and then salute immediately, and then he moves. And then you got to halt it, salute again and all that. So just make sure he's all the way stopped and then salute. Other than that, it was really good.
I got kind of confused when you said...
I know, yeah, we got confused on the calling. So
we're
going to try
it. Yeah, and I think what I need to do the next time is... They've got these sections, and I think I need to read all the words in one section at a time. Even though it might be really early, Teresa, like A, enter working trot, X, halt, salute, proceed working trot. I'm going to say the whole mouthful at once, and then be quiet. And then, like, when it comes down to the giant four-sentence thing, I'm going to say the whole thing all done, and then
the
be quiet.
Circle?
Because otherwise, I'm still trying to read it while the next
circle?
Move is ready to start, and I'm late, and I can't help you, you know?
Are you talking about the stretch circle?
No, yes.
We could even just, you know it's a stretch circle down there at A, right? You could probably even just
say. Can I just say stretch circle?
Yeah, you could just say stretch circle at A.
I didn't know that was a stretch circle.
Yeah, you did. You did it.
I did it?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's just in the description, it's like allowing the horse to stretch, blah, blah, blah. Just say stretch circle. Because otherwise, by the time she finishes reading it, it's already time for the next movement, and then we're late to the next movement.
Right.
So does that work for you? Mm-hmm. If when it's time for the stretch circle, we'll just say at A, do the stretch circle.
Okay.
That way, yeah.
And I also know that Karen's right when I wanted to.
Yeah.
And I messed up on the circle, didn't I?
Yeah, but you just thought it was at this end. It was still shaped very nicely. It was just make sure that it's at B instead of at the end.
Okay.
Other than that, it was fun. Mm-hmm. But yes. Okay, so let's try it again.
Okay.
All right.
Well,
corners.
On your way down.
Yeah. Sorry.
Well, go. You do your list.
I was
you
just going to say corners, and then just make sure that, well, corners.
Yeah. Okay, well, yeah. You do corners. Okay, so imagine you're at E, going to make a 20-meter circle, and I'm at E, going to make a 20-meter circle. Where was our horses running with each other? They're at E, and I'm at E, and we're making our 20-meter circle in the middle. Okay, well,
just make your horse stand there until they poop.
It was easy. She'll do it again, I'm sure. Give me a second to get ready, Teresa. Ready when you are.
Yep, ready when you are.
Ready. All right. A, enter, working trot. X, halt, salute. Proceed, working trot.
Yes, so support him with that outside rein. There you go. There you go. Good, good correction there. You were able to straighten him back up. There you go. Good.
C, track right. B, circle right. 20 meters.
So watch the bend again. Don't let them be over bent going down the wall. There, good correction. There you go. Much better, Teresa. Much better. Good. Got them. I'm trying to keep them straight. No indirect rein. I see your rein.
Between C and H. Working canter.
Good.
Left lead.
Better. That's a little early.
E. Circle left. 20 meters.
Your hands are going with him a little bit more this time. Good. A little bit big on the circle on that side.
Between.
Oops. Sorry.
So do you see what I'm talking about, Janice, as far as the circle shape?
Yeah.
Okay. And then this is your stretch circle at A.
Am I lost?
Yep.
Yeah.
Good. There you go. Just find the stretch circle at A. There. Good. Yep. Letting them stretch down a little bit. Good.
Before A, shorten the reins. A, working trot.
Luckily, I've seen it so many times now, I know what I'm doing. Between A and F, walk.
Thank you. It's so hard.
F, a walk.
Change room.
There you go.
Medium
good.
Walk.
And this is that weird triangle thing. So, yeah. Don't let him lose the impulsion in the walk. There you go. There. Much better. Yep. All the way to E and then to M.
E to M. Change rein. Free walk. M. Medium walk.
There you go. Yeah. So just make sure you're getting all the way to E there. There. That's very pleasant. Good.
C, working trot. E, circle left, 20 meters.
So maybe that's something you can help her with, Jay. Let's see how she'll do this really big, super huge side of one circle. And then when she comes back around to B, she'll just kind of cut off. Like, see how big that side was? And then, so we just need to work on that circle shape. Because look, once she hits B, she's going to pull off.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we'll just. To the end or something?
Yeah, no, we can even put cones out or something if you want to. They're all the way back to E. They're good.
F, X, H, change rein.
Am I right?
Yep. There, good. There, very nice corner there. Yeah, make sure it's straight on the diagonal. Good.
Between C and M, working canter, right knee.
Good, very nice transition there.
B, circle right, 20 meters. Between B and F, working trot. A, down center line, X, halt, salute.
Good turn on your center line there, good. And it's nice and straight. Yep, set him up for that halt transition. Good. Oh, don't ever do that in front of a judge. They will kill you for that. There you go. Good. That's okay. That was really good. I could tell that he was about to move, and I don't think you could tell he was about to move because he hadn't quite squared up his front feet, and I think he wanted to square up his front feet. So, yeah. But, word of warning, don't ever hit your horse in front of a judge. They will literally burn you.
Sorry, but
oh, no.
He deserved it. I mean,
no.
Well, no.
No, a horse never deserves it.
He didn't.
No.
He was trying to get his feet squared up
because
he knows that you want his front feet lined up and he knows that you want his back feet lined up. And he was just like right there wanting to put that front foot forward, but he knew that you wanted him to stop. And so he was like, what do I do? So then finally he was like, okay, I'm just going to do it. And so then he did it and his feet were squared up now, but you know, he moved. So yeah, that's okay. But yes, don't hit him in front of the judge. However, that was much better, don't you think?
Yeah.
I thought that was much more pleasant. Excellent corrections on your corners there. I thought that, wasn't it easier to go across the diagonal when you go way deep in those corners? And so that made your diagonal straighter, it made his bend better across the diagonal, so those corners were really, really good there.
And what about my circles?
Yeah, circles were better. I think we just need to work on when you have a circle when it's not at the end. But, I mean, I don't even do good circles, so don't feel bad. So we just need to make sure that they're even on both sides. But it was better than the first time, for sure. And you'll see what we're talking about. If you watch the videos, you'll see. It's just like one side is big and then the other side is small. So we just need to, like, scoot it back a little bit. But if that's all you have to work on, come on. You're fine. The center line, both turns to the center line were really good because you supported him more with that outside rein, and so he wasn't throwing his shoulder out coming in, and so he was much straighter both times. So that was good. Just make sure that you're coming all the way up as close as you can to B, or whatever this is, C, before you turn. Other than that, it was good. Your canter transitions both directions were good, and you were able to keep the canter the whole time, which was nice. He had a very pleasant...
He was slow.
Yeah, he had a very pleasant pace, right? Which I thought so as well, so that was good. And then, yeah. Did you see anything else?
I thought you tried and got into some of those corners a lot better this time. Like, you know, I could see...
And it made a difference because, it, like I said, it lined up that diagonal where she was able to be straight down and that was good.
Yeah, and I thought you had a lovely free walk. I only got to peek at it a little bit because I was trying so hard to read. You know.
Yes, but the free walk was good, yes. And the second one, too, you didn't let him break, I don't think, on this one?
No, I'm pushing him.
Yeah, and so you pushed him forward without letting him trot, which was really nice. And so he did very well with that. The only thing was you turned at, like, the center or the quarter line. You didn't go all the way to the wall and then all the way back. But that's a minor thing. I mean, just walk two extra steps. That's not that hard to fix. So, but, yes, just make sure you're making it all the way to the letter. But, yeah, I was actually, I thought the best part about it was your canter transitions, honestly. And that's one of the things that you had trouble with. So I think that was a huge step forward for him, was those canter transitions were really good. And then back down to the trot transitions were really good as well. So I was happy with it. I was much happier with the second one than the first one.
Yeah.
Don't you think?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. I was just making sure that that wasn't just me.
Yeah, he was listening more to me than the first one. He was like, oh, whatever.
Yeah, and well, and I think he had just, it also might have been the fact that he had been standing for so long, and then the first test he had to kind of get re-warmed up, and then the second one he was on his game, you know? Mm-hmm. So I think that could have made a difference as well.
So that's something to know for if we go to a dressage show, we got to warm him up a little.
Yeah,
first.
Warm him up a little before you go into the test. And so, you know, because you know how it is at a show, especially. You're standing around, waiting around outside the ring, and then he gets all kind of like, okay, I'm going to fall asleep, you know. Mm-hmm. And then you got to re-get everything. So just make sure that you allow yourself enough time to re-warm up a little bit before heading into the ring. Other than that, it was good.
I'm going to hit. Is there a place where I can lunge him before we start the show?
Yeah, they have a round pin just for lunging, and then they have a big arena that's like twice. Like if you put two of these side by side, there'll be plenty of room.
I just need to know that he's not gonna buck.
Yeah. Okay. Well, you see how much groundwork. Can I give you this?
Yes.
Warm up for you online, right? You better believe I'll be doing a lot of.